Today we celebrate the feast of the dedication of the Lateran Basilica. This is celebrated every year on the 9th of November. And for me, it is a very significant date. I can never forget the 9th of November for so many reasons. In the very first instance, it is my late brother's birthday, my elder brother, Teddy Ezehi. I always remember him on his birthday. And again, because of the feast I will celebrate today, I studied in Rome. I did my licentiate and my doctorate at the Università Lateranense, Lateran University in Rome. And my school was right behind this basilica. And the very main part of my stay in Rome, I spent 5 years in Rome, very part of my first stay in Rome before I decided to do my doctorate, I stayed at the Collegio Lateranese, Lateran College. And usually we move from Viale Alessandrino, pass through, we come up on a tram, we trek through the Lateran Basilica. Quite often we pass through the Basilica, and by the side or through the Basilica itself, if there are no activities in the Basilica. And so it is something that is nostalgic. I always remember. So whenever we talk about the Lateran Basilica, I remember because I lived in the Lateran in Rome. I studied, I lived in Lateran College. I studied in the Lateran University. So I actually prayed in the Lateran, joined the masses at the Lateran Basilica. So it was a very wonderful privilege to be part of those who had this experience. And every time we had this celebration of the Lateran Basilica every November night, we were in school. Unless it was on a Sunday. So we'll be in the college. Even at that, we talk about it. But I always remember my brother on this day, even when we were in Rome, he was still alive then. So I remember I used to tell my friends my brother's birthday. So for so many reasons, I would never forget the Lateran Basilica. Lateran Basilica is one of the four big basilicas in Rome. Of course, it is in fact the chief of the basilicas because it is the Pope's own cathedral. So we say bishops have cathedrals. The Lateran Basilica is the Pope's own cathedral, where in his capacity of the Pope, he is bishop. It is his own cathedral. And the Lateran Basilica has a very special place in the heart of Christians because it is the mother church, being the cathedral of the Pope. It is the first of the churches, and in fact typifies every other church. That is why today, when we celebrate the Lateran Basilica, we talk about churches. So it is raised by the church to the level of a feast. That's why you see we sang the Gloria this morning, because it is a feast in the church. In the readings, we are told about the cleansing of the church by Jesus. When we talk about church these days, you know, we due to the pandemic times and, you know, the coronavirus, certain places are almost brought down the level of respect, understanding of the church as church. We talk about church here, the building is important, but we actually talk about members who constitute the church. Whether as building or as members, people almost reduce their level of understanding of the church. But as church, it is important that we get to know, like I mentioned, that it's not just the building, but the human beings who are members of the church. That's why Jesus had to cleanse the church. He cleansed the church to make the people know that God's presence is there. He asked them to remove the idea of business from the worship that they ought to undertake in the church. Cleansing the church by Jesus was a call to prayer, the use of the church, of the gathering, of the building for what it was supposed to be. So if they gather in that building that has been dedicated to God, what they ought to do is to pray and to talk to God. And so he was cleansing the church, cleansing the building, and cleansing the people who lived and stayed in the church. That is what is important. The church is good. It is important to know the church as a building, yes. Like we're in the church today, it's a building. But it's the people that constitute the church. Without us, there will be no church. But the building is important because once we build and erect a structure and call it the church and dedicate it to God, God's presence is here. God dwells here. And when we gather, we encounter God. It's a very special place. But all the more important are the persons who come in. So that's why we did not want to overemphasize the importance of the individuals during the pandemic time, so that they don't fall into the problem of what we are trying to battle today and work out again for them to understand the importance of coming together. However, as Jesus cleansed the church, he also tests the people that he himself is the church, that we as a church. He says to them, I will destroy these and I will raise it up in 3 days. We're talking about his body. He is the church. He is the tabernacle. He is the center of our worship. He is himself the church. Each of us constitute the church. We are members of God's household. St. Paul says today, we are the temple of God. We are God's temple. If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy him. You are the temple of the Most High God, the living temple of the Holy Trinity. Everybody, you are the temple of Most High God, the living temple of the Holy Trinity. I want us to try to picture it in a certain sense of Jesus cleansing you as a temple of God. Rather than doing other things that are not meant for you as a child of God, with that temple which is of God, do the things of God. Rather than not pursuing evil things, evil thoughts, evil desires, rather than not pursuing things that will benefit them, but pursue the things that bring God dwelling into you, holiness of life, sanctity, obedience to God, prayer. These are the things that Lord Jesus desires us to do. These are the things that he invites us to do. So as we reflect on the cleansing of the temple and the celebration of the Feast of the Lateran Basilica, let us also dedicate ourselves to God. Let us once again remember that as children of God, we are called to holiness of life. Let us use the temple, which ourselves, our body, for God's work. Let us dedicate, let all that we do, think, and walk be what brings glory to God. The work of your hands. Jesus today abhorred trading in the temple and cleansed the temple. We submit ourselves to him, he will cleanse us. He will make us holy. So let us remember that as children of God, we are required to be holy all of the time. Let God dwell in our heart. Let us begin to think about God, conceive of the right in our hearts, always, and not evil, and not things that will bring glory to the devil. Because when you think about God, God will dwell in you. He will lead you and direct you. We pray this day, therefore, that the Lord himself, who cleansed the temple, will come to dwell in our hearts, will cleanse us all, make us holy, and help us to do things that will bring us to eternal life. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.